The demolition was the culmination of a lengthy legal battle. Israel's Supreme Court ruled in January that the land on which the homes were constructed had been under Jewish ownership since 1974 and that documents presented by the Palestinian families to support their claims had been forged. The families argued they had bought the plots in good faith and believed they were the rightful owners. "I built my house with my own hands. It is where I brought up my children. This is where they grew up," Shawamra said, as the Hyundai digger went to work. "We took down the houses for fear of seeing settlers move in, and having to see them inside the house." The Israel Land Fund, whose stated goal is acquiring all the land of Israel for the Jewish people, advertised on its website after the court decision 6 months ago for four idealistic families willing to move into the homes. Most countries consider settlement activity on territory Israel occupied in 1967 as illegal. Israel disputes this. Shawamra said the demolition cost 30,000 shekels, $8,200, and that he had turned down offers of money from Israeli settlers to leave the buildings standing. Friends, neighbors, and the newly homeless families watched glumly on a hillside in Beit Hanina as dust rose into the air. Shawamra's neighbor Zianat Abu Rumaili, 62, cried as she sat beside the other demolished home, in a tent that she said had been provided by the Palestinian Authority, which exercises limited self-rule in the occupied West Bank.